Last week, I made a video going over customizing the lighting in iCUE version 4, and for those now wanting some help with what Corsair is now calling key assignments, well, you know, you saw the video title, so yeah, we're gonna go over that in this video. In order to make key assignments, we first need to create a profile to associate those key assignments with. So the first thing we're going to do is click on the profile menu drop-down here in the upper left of our iCUE window and click on this big plus sign to create a new profile. iCUE is all about customization. So even here, you can choose one of these icons to represent your profile. Click on this paint bucket and choose a color, or come back and click on this plus sign and use any picture you want that you have on your PC. To keep things simple for this video though, I'm just going to pick this green one. In this field, we can give our profile a name. Let's say you want this profile to have some custom key assignments for your favorite game. So let's name it that. Here we can choose an image or video to use as a background in the iCUE window. And lastly, clicking on this big plus sign here, we can link our profile to an application. So since this profile is a custom layout for your favorite game, we can link the executable file for that game to this profile here, so that when we launch our game, iCUE will automatically switch to our custom profile for us. With our new profile created, we can now start making custom key assignments. I don't want this video to be super long, and I'm sure you don't either, so I'm going to go over a few of the different key assignments to show you how iCUE works. And then it'll be up to you to use that basic knowledge to make whatever custom key assignments you want to make. I'm going to start by clicking on my Corsair keyboard here, and then click on Key Assignments here on the left. To add a new assignment, we'll first click on this plus sign. And here are the different assignment options we have. There's two different categories, remap and regular. Under remap, we have keystroke, language keys, mouse, and then keyboard. Keystroke allows us to remap a key or series of key presses on our keyboard or mouse to any key or mouse button of our choosing. You just click in this field here, and then either press the key you want to assign on your keyboard itself, or click it in the GUI up here. In the field to the right, you then press the key or keystroke you want that key to be remapped to. And that's it. You can also click on Advanced here and toggle this option on, which has the key retain its original output in addition to executing your custom keystroke. The language keys remap, I'm not familiar with at all because I've never messed with that. So if that's something you want to do, you're going to have to figure that out on your own. Mouse allows us to assign a mouse button function to a key on our keyboard, and then keyboard allows us to remap any key on our keyboard to function as any other key on our keyboard. For example, if I wanted to use left control as a spacebar, I can click on this question mark block, press control, and then select the key I wanted to function as here, in this case the spacebar. In the Advanced tab, we can once again choose to retain the original key output on top of executing our new function, as well as have a single press imitate holding that key down. In this dropdown that appears, we can then choose to have it act as a toggle, meaning it will act as if you're pressing the key until you press it again, or using on key press, we can set it to imitate holding the key for a certain amount of time, which we can specify in this field. This is a nice feature for games where you have to hold a key down to open a door or search an area or object or whatever. Under the regular category, we first have text, which allows us to type out a message of some kind and assign it to a key so that when we want to have that message typed out in a game chat or something, all you have to do is hit your assigned key, and that message will be instantly typed out. In the Advanced tab, there's a lot of additional options that go along with this, one of them being adding a delay between character inputs to make it look like you're typing it, I guess. But I'll let you play around with those if that's something you're interested in. For now, I would like to keep moving. Media is a tool to reassign keys on your keyboard to act as media control keys. So you can pause, play, skip forward or backward, and turn the volume up and down while you're listening to music or watching videos on your computer. Launch app basically lets you create hotkeys to launch your favorite applications, as well as some commonly used Windows applications like a web browser and one of my favorites, the calculator. So instead of double clicking an icon on your desktop or looking it up in your Windows start menu, you can simply press a single key on your keyboard and that application will launch. Disable does exactly what you would think it does. It renders whatever key with that assignment inoperable. If you don't want it to be disabled all the time though, you can toggle this radio button to only disable it if the Windows lock button is on, which is a nice option to have available. Next on the list is profile switching. I use this key assignment on my strafe keyboard so I can switch from one profile to another quickly and easily. You can choose to have whatever key you assign it to switch directly to a particular profile, or have it cycle through a list of profiles you choose, which is the option I prefer to use. I then like to hit this option here to copy this assignment to all the profiles on the list, so then no matter which profile I'm using, my profile switching key works. And with that, we are on to our final key assignment option, macro. For those of you that want to use this feature, I assume you already know what a macro is. But for those that don't know, a macro is a way to assign a series of button presses to a single button press. In some games, you have to press a few different keys to execute an attack or cast a spell or something else. Creating a macro is a great way to simplify things and make you faster and more efficient. To create a macro in iCUE 4, you first want to click on the question mark box here and then choose the key you want to be the trigger for your macro. For this example, I'm going to assign mine to the E key. Now I'm going to come over here to the General tab and we have some different options we can turn on and off. If we don't want any delays between our key presses, we can toggle this option off. We of course want to record all keyboard events, which is just the keys we press while recording our macro. And then I also want to turn mouse clicks on because I want my macro to end with a left mouse click. This way, all I'll have to do is point the mouse where I want to execute my macro and then press the key on my keyboard and iCUE will take care of all the rest. I'll now go back to the recording tab, click the record button here, and start inputting my macro. I'm first going to type the E key and then F and end with a left click. I'll then stop the recording and it recorded that mouse click too. I guess that's not a bad thing though. It gives me an opportunity to show you what to do if you record something you didn't want to record. Each event here has three little dots by it, so I'm going to click on this one and it brings up the options for that event. I can add an event above or below, edit the event, copy the event, or delete it, which is what I want to do. Now let's delete this mouse click event, and there, that's our macro. Now when I press the E key on my keyboard, that macro will play. Just in case you're wondering, this isn't for any real game. I'm just making something up to show you how to do it. There's also the three little dots here that allow you to do some other things like add other events, aka key presses to your macro, add a delay between events, delete delays between events, and if your macro is all messed up and you just need to start over, you can delete all events here and start over fresh. In the Advanced tab, we can choose to retain the original key output, change when our action is triggered, whether to repeat the action or not, and give the macro a second assignment. So yeah, you can create another macro and then link it to your first macro here, so it will execute both of them, one right after the other. You then also have the option to assign a sound effect to play on your PC when you use your macro, as well as have a custom lighting effect play on your keyboard. Crap, this video is already longer than I was wanting it to be. Well, then I guess it's good that I'm done talking about everything then, isn't it? I really hope this video was helpful to you, that it helped familiarize you with the iCUE interface and gave you the confidence that you need to start trying things out and set up your own custom key assignments. I know most of you have already left by now, but those of you that are still watching, there's those YouTube things you can do that really help a lot. And there's also a link to my Amazon store in the video description where you can check out many of the products I feature in my videos, like the Corsair Strafe RGB keyboard I used in this video. Thank you so much. Have a great day, and we'll see you in the next one.